control over local government units as well as the DILG. What is he, Secretary of the Department of Interior and Local Government, if he is feeble to act on crisis situation? I would understand how the distinguished gentleman Palmerengake would like to defend his allies in this administration. But because of that partisan loyalty, he is blinded from the realities of the situation.
Madam Speaker, perhaps the distinguished minority leader does not really want to talk about partisan loyalty, because I can review the events that transpired during the 14th Congress, during the 13th Congress, when our distinguished minority leader played a very crucial role in killing resolutions and all kinds of initiatives. But I don't want to discuss that. May I remind the distinguished minority leader about what happened during the early months of the Ramos administration? Secretary Aluna tried to appoint certain provincial directors, certain heads of police organizations at the local level. Senator Ople stood up and objected, and Senator Ople was sustained in his objection that the Secretary of Interior and Local Government has no authority to appoint provincial directors and other officials of the Philippine National Police. He must go through the process. That is one example of the Secretary of Interior and Local Government having no effective control over the Philippine National Police. The minority leader, the single minority leader, has conveniently forgotten this very celebrated case involving then DILG Secretary Aluna under a very assertive president of the Republic of the Philippines, who knew about the Philippine constabulary, who knew about the police, but he yielded to the principle that the DILG Secretary cannot, without the consent of the local officials, appoint and designate provincial directors. The minority leader must have forgotten this already. After all, it's been, this was in 1992, so I can understand if he has forgotten this. But let me go to things that are more recent with respect to command responsibility and the dedication of our distinguished minority leader to the principle of command responsibility. May I know, Madam Speaker, whether the Sikhist minority leader stood up and invoked command responsibility when there was a bomb blast here in the House of Representatives that killed a colleague of ours? Did our Sikhist minority leader stand up during that time to invoke command responsibility and ask for the resignation of people that he thought was responsible on the principle of command responsibility, or did he conveniently just remain quiet?
Your Honor, that bombing incident in the House is not a relevant situation. But what is relevant, Madam Speaker, is that we are in the budget process starting today. And in the budget process, the Secretary of the Department of the Interior Local Government represents the PNP as an attached agency. Although there is a summary presentation made by PNP, but still the PNP's budget is overseen by the Secretary. So much so that no realignment in the budget of the PNP could be effected without the imprimatur of the Secretary of the Department of the Interior and Local Government. The latest example is the request of the Philippine Director General Jesus Versosa, Chief of the Philippine National Police, for realignment of 230 million from the modernization fund for 2010 of PNP. He cannot do this without invoking the authority to make this realignment by the Secretary of DILG. So much so that his request for realignment was made by Secretary Robredo to the Department of Budget and Management. I have here a copy of the first endorsement dated 25 August 2010 from Secretary Jesse Robredo. And I would like to read this into the records of this chamber. It says, Department of the Interior and Local Government, Office of the Secretary, first endorsement, 25 August 2010. Respectfully forwarded to the Honorable Secretary Lorenzo Villalar, Secretary of Budget and Management, the attached letter from PD General Jesus A. Versosa, Chief Philippine National Police, requesting for the realignment of 230 million pesos through the release of a special allotment release order, SARO, and its corresponding notice of cost allocation, NCA, to be sourced from the unreleased 1.230 billion PNP modernization program. Of the said amount, 50 million will be realigned to MOE to be used for the training of the special weapons and tactics, SWAT teams, and the balance of 180 million pesos will be used for the procurement of ISO anti-terrorism equipment. Signed, Jesse M. Robredo, Secretary. This would only manifest very clearly the authority of the Secretary.